And the Nigerian Customs Service says the recent partial closure of the nation's borders along the four zones of the South-South, the Southwest, the North-Central and the Northwest has curbed the smuggling of about 10.2 litres of petrol out of the country on a daily basis. The Comptroller General of Customs, Colonel Hamid Ali, retired while briefing newsmen in Abuja on the activities of the Joint Border Security Exercise, codenamed Operation Swift Response, said the exercise, which is being supervised by the Office of the National Security Advisor, has recorded several successes, which include curbing banditry, smuggling, illegal immigration, and the proliferation of small arms and light weapons, among others.
The partial closure has so far curbed the smuggling of foreign rice into the country, in addition to other prohibited items. Our series of interactions and engagement with Rice Miller Association of Nigeria since the commencement of the exercise has shown that the border closure has enhanced more production and milling of Nigerian rice. Patronage of Nigerian rice has increased and farmers are expanding their farms as well as engaging more hands. Furthermore, the border closure has impacted positively on revenue generation of the federal government, which in turn will be used to build more infrastructures, develop critical sectors of the nation's economy. The border exercise has also curbed diversion of petroleum products from Nigeria to neighboring countries. As it is, the last report is that our consumption of PMS, that's petroleum product, has reduced by 10.2%, I mean 10.2 million liters. Which then means that 10.2 million liters has continuously been smuggled to our neighboring countries. Also, the last report I received is that the market sells garri, amala, ugbo, and other food items are now smiling to their mouth because the influx of the foreign rice has either continuously adversely affect their own market because the rice has become so cheap, it's available for everybody, and it has become a staple food on everybody's table. But now that the rice is beginning to be scarce, and only those who can afford can buy, now we are going back to our local and traditional food, which to us is a good news.
728 people have been removed, which is a great issue. But among the people who we have arrested people who are not even members of the ECOWAS at the border. We have arrested Pakistanis. We have arrested North Koreans at the borders. And those people are supposed to be deported. We have deported around 7 of them. 20 of them will be deported. We are getting for connection to make sure they reach North Korea. So it means they have taken advantage of the weak borders we have to enter Nigeria, even though they are not expected to enter. So we have arrested these people and we are deporting them. They have been banned for life, then they cannot come back to Nigeria for trying to enter Nigeria through an unorganized port of entry. So my emphasis on this matter is that as long as we have illicit goods, we equally have illicit people. You are aware that the threat to national security is not only goods, are also people who are terrorists, who are bandits, who are kidnappers. And we are not saying we are the only kidnappers, but we are all the unkidnappers, but we are stopping movement across the borders. You will agree with me that with the closure of the border, there has been reduction. And a lot of banditry, kidnapping, it's very clear there has been reduction. So as far as we are concerned, the security of this country is also related to the movement of persons. We should continue, as I said, for immigration, we shall continue patrolling the borders and ensure people enter through the recognized port and depart through the recognized port.
As we strive to address critically the economic and security concerns of smuggling and irregular migration, by extension it has also reduced the scale of other transnational organized crimes like proliferation of small arms and light weapons, terrorist activities, as well as anti-banditry operations that have been going on. So I think this is something that we should all give credit to ourselves, not only to the participating security agency, but also the members of the populace, because they have been very, very cooperative based on the reports we have been receiving expressly from the field.